Hey traders, what is going on? Welcome back to another video. This video here is the start of something a little new, more of just a experiment for myself. We're gonna take the next few months, not sure how long, I haven't detailed that in the plan yet, but this is basically the start of that, where I took $200, deposited it into this account, this Canadian account, and it came out as $75, whatever, after it got sent. So we're just here, and the EA took its first few trades on first four trades, right? One, two, three, four. On these pairs, I've set them all up. They're all rejecting the support, and the other ones rejecting resistance, if that is the trend. We'll go through and have more of an explanation for why we're taking trades. I'm going to break down some trades in this as well. Simply enough, last week, we can tell by these vertical lines here that the week opened here and closed here. So we had a bullish week, and we're using that as the bias to help us determine what we're looking for next week. Are we looking for long opportunities or short opportunities? So in this case, we have what price came and did was rejected the support. Price rose up, came back down, rejected the support. We got a very indecisive candle here with the low being down here, but the close still being up here, rejecting this support. And then price coming up back with a bullish candle. So we're gonna go enter on that position, stop loss at the other side of the zone. And our TP, we are gonna adjust as we go through and approach these highs and stuff like that. This is a semi-automatic expert advisor that I'm using, so I have to work with it as well. Yeah, we're just gonna work with some of these positions. Let's go over. So we took one pound yen, pound New Zealand. We took one on G, right? So same thing, price rejected. Last week was a bullish week from start to end, right? So this week we're just looking for these bullish opportunities to continue. Same thing here, where we had the open here, close here, give us a bullish bias. This whole week, we're gonna look for that buying opportunity from like down here over in this area to go back up to the upside and turn a profit that way. Same thing here, we're looking for the rejection of these supports, these floor areas to go to the upside, and we'll manage our stop loss, we'll reduce our stop loss, stuff like this. This is just part one, but the MyFX book is gonna go into how much our losses actually are in a percentage wise. According to how our profits are, what are the percentage, the pip, just how everything overall adds up. So these are our first few positions that we're taking. This is the first little cut for this. We just funded the account today. These are the first trades that are happening since the 9 o'clock close. These trades are being taken on the 4 hour candle close. And yeah, we will work with this and see how they go. I will catch you in a little for the next update. This is what is going on. Welcome back to another video. Right now, we have something to talk about. I've been running this little test starting last week, and I plan to drop in the little clip when I started it. Basically, took $200, put in this account, and this is the June run. So I just closed out of the trades yesterday, so I'm just going to look at some of the results. I haven't really been through all of them yet. All the things on the MyFX books, I haven't really got to look at and stuff like that. But I wanted to do this before I updated my charts. That way we can actually still get to see where these support and resistances are and some of these trades we took. So let's start here. So these are the results for the week, the little experiment that I'm running. The little test run that I'm doing. So this is the June run for the TPA EA. So all these trades are being taken. All these trades are being taken by the EA, which I show right there, TPASR. So that's why all these support and resistances are placed here. Like we took some trades on these at the beginning of the week, had a really bullish week. Even next week is still looking to get bullish. Still looking to be bullish, but what I'm doing is I'm just going to update my charts, reapply those support and resistances, and look for new opportunities longwards. But yeah, this would still be bullish, and we took some trades on AJ, crazy bull run from last week. That's why those support and resistance are still in there. GJ also had a crazy bull run, right, from last week. Still looking for those bullish opportunities to continue. We just have to see how the market structure plays up and adds to the whole story of things. But yeah, back to this. So what we basically can see here is from, we started this 2 weeks ago, or now is exactly 2 weeks. So this started on the 22nd here. And basically this just shows, so we were taking some small losses in the account. And these are basically showing the daily losses, how much was lost each day, those red little boxes. And then this line just shows that the balance was actually decreasing. And then the yellow line here shows the equity. So my main focus was just maintaining the equity at a break-even state, or, you know, sometimes it goes a bit above and a bit below, but that is a result of this test, basically. Just noticing that, yes, the balance did increase, but at any point in time, I could have closed the trade that was in profit, and the equity would still be at a break-even standpoint, or just near a break-even standpoint, you know. We're just above break-even here. This one, we're just below break-even, just above. And then this, we actually close out on some of our trades because towards the end of the week, as you already know, like I already said, I close out the trade. So by the end of the week, I was looking to wrap up some of these trades. So we close some of them here. And one thing to notice as well is, even though we're taking these losses, this is the small losses that we're taking each day, you know, taking a lot of trades. And the EA does take many trades. You can see down here, it took 94 trades within the 2 weeks. We'll go into a lot of those other details, but 94 trades, 2 weeks. We've been cutting our losers short, right? And that's important. We've been cutting our losers short and securing our winners. So even though we're taking these losses, we still have winning trades on our side that we have secured in case they fall back on us. They can close, and then we'll result in a, that trade will result in a profit, right? Those things are combatants against this equity curve, this growth curve downwards, right? And then when we actually close out on those winners that we are holding, right here is where we close out on all the positions. So that's when everything added up, and then we closed up in a positive. Okay, so what we can see is over this whole time, we have a 21% win rate, which is, you know, you just have to make sense of it. What is the risk to reward ratio compared to the win rate? And does that make sense? I talk about this in the 7 principles of trading. You know, your whole trading plan is determined, your whole trading plan success rate is determined on 2 important factors, which is going to be, what is your win rate and what is your risk to reward ratio? And other thing is, how do you manage these trades? And those things will determine your profitability in trading. So you need to figure out what those numbers are and what you want to do with them. Okay. So at the end of the whole time, we have 130% increase. Like I said, we took $200, we put it in the Bitcoin machine, sent it straight to this account, came out as $75. So we lost $25 in fees, which the worst part is using a Bitcoin machine, but these days that is just what it is. So one thing I want to mention as well, like I said, we're holding winning positions this entire time. So even though the drawdown is at 99% basically, we would still be able to hold a negative drawdown in the account while still being able to close a profit. Okay, so this is important to look at. Took 94 trades. Okay, I believe, where was it, this, so we won 20 out of 94 trades, which represents a 91% win rate, right? This doesn't seem the best, but as you see, they still had positive results. You'll notice I didn't take any take profits on these trades. And that is mainly because I didn't put any take profits on these trades, mainly because I do want to try to maximize my profits. I'm trying to cut all my losers short and quickly as possible. And then for my winners, I want to do my best not to close them, but to secure them. More they go up, more they go in my direction, the more I secure them. And then when they decide to turn around,
that's when the trade actually closes, okay? So we netted 1,000 pips, about basically 1,100 pips, and our average win is 142, while our average loss is 24 pips. So this is where you get your idea for your risk to reward, okay? So we're about risking one for, I want to say, six, maybe, something like that. Risk one for five, risk one for four. But I generally aim for, on each trade, at least risk one for three. And then what is good about this is that this is actually an average, right? So it shows us on all the trades that we actually close out of, how does that fare in the risk reward? And it's pretty good in this case. It's more than risk one to gain three, right? Our average length is about a day. Our best trade we held for 434 pips, and our worst trade was 100. So that again shows our general risk to reward of about risk one for four. Okay, that shows us what we see over here. Okay, and if we actually just look at some of the trades here, let's put them in order. I'm gonna go into the actual charts and show some of these, but you're gonna get a good idea for what some of these trades look like, where we lose 1.5, we lose two, we lose one, we lose two, we lose six. We go through these losses, but then we come through on our winners and they make up for these losses that we ended up taking. I really just consider the losses as part of doing business. They're just transactions. I'm literally just taking trades with a system in place that has an edge in my outcome, which has an edge in my favor. So that is what I'm really keeping in my mind and playing to. So as the EA was taking these trades, it went through. As price comes to these support and resistance, if price ever decides to stumble, it might knock me out and put me back in the trade. It's really just taking trades at the rejections of these support and resistances. But yeah, they go through these small losses. So small losses, break even, small wins, those all those things happen. And then we have the big wins, which we're actually looking for. These ones, which are going to cover a few of these losses. Boom, the losses get a little bit bigger here. Well, nonetheless, we come through. Okay, so here was the deposit, and then here we have some of these trades that just get set in here. Let's scroll up. So we're just knocking out some of these losing trades. We are end up taking some trades that do end up being held until the end of the week, stuff just like that, as we close out on these positions. You know, like I said, we're just looking to get winning positions and hold on to those positions, use them to maximize our gains, make up for these losses, things just like that, right? So it's just a crazy streak of losses. Closed out on some of our winners here as we're profiting crazily on GJ. We took our original position here, took it around here, and then we added those two positions. Same thing here. So this is when we actually go through and try to close out on our winning positions. These just end up making up for those losers, and we end up having a nice profit gain, right? So it's just looking at last week. Was last week a bullish or bearish week? Like in this case, it was a bullish week. So next week or last week, when we actually were trading this, we're looking for bullish opportunities, any rejections of supports to continue onwards, and that's what we got. Okay, same thing here, looking for the rejection of the support and resistance, and that's what we got. If I go to GJ, I know I can do this, drag and drop, and we see exactly where we got in and where we got out on the chart. If I go over to this, should be able to see exactly where we got in and where we got out, right? So I set this up on the weekend as soon as the market opened, seeing that there was a rejection of this line, this horizontal box, which I have basically labeled as a support or resistance, this case support, because last week was a bullish week, right? So I'm looking for bullish opportunities. Price went up and that's where it closed. Let's look at another AJ. Really good week, really good trade taken by the EA, and then I just held it, right? So we entered on the rejection of this support. Like I said, so we entered one around here too. This resulted in a loss as price came back to retest the support. But then we got a bullish close from the support, which is good things for us. So from then we've just held. This week, so at the end of every week, I consider closing or staying in the position, right? This week resulted as a bullish week. So because of that, the profits were still small. I'm like, I'll hold it into next week because the bias would still be the same. I'd still be looking for the same thing, right? So I've carried the position next week, and it's the same case for next week where I still am looking for bullish opportunities, and I did close last week. So I'm just starting fresh, looking for new opportunities, right? But I think you guys get the gist. There's some pairs over here for USD, right? We were trading this short as well. If I can find the trade we took on that, right? So we took it from last week all the way down here. Still, we can just look for more bearish opportunities next week on the rejection of like this level here. Up here as well. I would just look for any type of rejections around these areas to just head back to the downside, looking to continue with what last week did. Sometimes you'll be wrong, sometimes you'll be right. Sometimes you won't have a continuing week, but you'll have opportunity to still take trades in that direction as if it were a continuing week and still pull a profit. So yeah, that's all I really want to say for this video, guys. It's just a reflection. It's just like a journal to see what actually happened over the little course of time while you're trading, you know, seeing that, okay, the balance stayed somewhat the same with the equity. The equity stayed somewhat the same. The balance decreased. We were able to cut our losers short. We were able to hold on to our winners. And we've seen what happened as the market actually started having a lot of momentum and trending, right? We were able to capitalize on these positions, and these ended up making up for our losing positions, which is basically the business model altogether, right? You're going to take losses, and your wins have to make up for your losses. We've seen that we had a 20% win rate, 21%. And our risk reward was about risk 1 for 4, something like that, right? So like I said, these things just have to make sense when you're taking your trades. These things have to make sense when you're taking trade. So all I really want to say for this video, guys, thank you for tuning in. Drop a comment. Let me know what other type of videos you guys want to see me make. Drop a like. Sub to the channel if you're not. I will be putting out some other videos on the other channel real soon, JD. But that being said, guys, I'll check you in the next video. Thank you for tuning in. Peace.